Radio Blast, the number one network of car radio, brings you the greatest entertainment that news can bring. With your host, John White.
Welcome, everybody, to the second episode of Radio Blast with your host, John White. You just caught me here in the middle of having a cigarette. So, it's June 14th, and here are the headlines today. City of London Police Superintendent arrested on suspicion of passing unauthorized information to journalist. In addition to live, the Croatia fight to back to draw 1-1 with Italy and stay top of Group C. That was an epic game from the Euro 2012. In addition, the rollout of NHS 111 number in England is to be delayed, the government announces. And former taxes billionaire Alan Stanford jailed for 110 years over fraudulent pyramid scheme. 110 years, that's a lot. What do you think? Send in your texts and emails here at the radio station. We hope to hear more from you. And also, ex-News International executive Rebecca Brooks told the Prime Minister professionally, "We're definitely in this together." The Leveson Inquiries hears. There's also other news you can check out on the official website for the news at CCB News. Obviously, we can't say the official name due to copyright infringement. But yes, only 70 days left before the Olympic Games begin. I hope all those people out there are getting ready for it. And it should be coming down to Dover sometime within the next couple of weeks. So stay tuned for that. So yes, you may hear a jingle outside. It's because we've had to have the window open, as you can hear the ice cream van outside. I want ice cream! Yes. As we were saying, let's put the music back on. I don't know why I had to turn that off. So today, on Radio Blast, I'm your host, John White. We have got three guests on our show today, ladies and gentlemen. In addition, we've also got a song being performed in a cappella form live here in the studio from one of our guests. So let's reveal our guests, ladies and gentlemen. We have got none other than this epic lineup. We've got a news track from Lady C's album again. We've also got El Paparando as a guest on the show, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, El Paparando, the man himself. We've also got Jill Marmalade here to talk about the Trash Talk Championships and her eyes of what a revolution should be. And our big star, who's continuously astounding the nation at the moment, is working on getting a new record label set for a new album. The actress and singer, and also co-member of Rainbow of Madness, Esha Ford, will be here later on. So first of all, El Paparando, let's get you on the show. Yes, it's so great to be here. Yes, El Paparando, it's been a very, very, it's been very hectic for you working for Rainbow of Madness, hasn't it not? Well, yes, I do have to say, on the minute, are you smoking in the studio? Can I have a puff of that fag? I didn't know you smoke. Sometimes, you know, it gets a little bit tense, yes. So can I have a puff of that? Go ahead. That was absolutely tasty, yes. So yes, El Paparando, let's get down to business. First of all, we want to talk about your rise and your rise in Rainbow of Madness. Also, we want to talk about your upcoming match against Lady C at Trash Talk Championships. We've also got some. We want to ask you about your time in Italy. But first, how did your trip in Italy go?
Well, it was absolutely amazing. My uncle was so happy to see me. He baked me a lovely feast. That was a fiesta of great things. You know, not many people in Italy like to welcome another culture into the streets, you know. And there was Spanish, you know, there was so much from on home there in Italy. It took me by surprise, yes.
And yes, we understand that you were received the key of Italy. What is this? You know, normally people get given the key to a city. You got given a key to an entire country.
Oh, no. You misinterpreted that. The key of Italy isn't actually like the same system as, you know, giving a key to, say, for instance, the key to Seattle or key to Washington. It's nothing like that. It's the key to Italy is like a medallion that they award you for all your great services that you do within the country, you know, because I donated a lot of my funding to a lot of children charities and helping to fund some schools. Obviously, I didn't donate a lot because I didn't have a lot at my disposal, but I wanted to sort of contribute. And throughout my entire time, even though it was supposed to be a vacation, all of my time was used to help others. And the mayor of, the governor of Italy, should I say, actually wanted to greet me in person last Friday. And after I went there, we had a nice drink, we had a lovely meal, and, did you two go on a romantic date?
No, of course not!
But me and his mamacita did, yes! Well, that was rude. Anyway, carry on. And so, there was a ceremony on Tuesday evening, because I actually flew back on Wednesday morning. I didn't get back to Dover in England for about at least 8:30, so I was absolutely tired, and I had a show to do on Wednesday. So I was really tired. I managed to get a bit of my show done. I had to do an advertisement for a holiday cruise. Then I went straight to bed. But I did have I woke up a bit later after that and, you know, sort of interrupted Lady C's show, which, bear in mind, wasn't really a good thing at all. But nonetheless. So, as you were saying about the key of Italy. Yes, they gave me the key of Italy as a medallion. It's 24-karat gold. It's very fragile. They told you not to supposed to pick it out of it. 22-karat gold, should I say. It's so beautiful to look at. I've got it at my home in Spain because I wanted it. You know, I wanted my children to be proud of me because I do have a daughter and a little son that I had with my ex-wife who I'm very close friends with now. But, you know, we can't get back together because, you know, at the time we were having the Rocky, it's a bit of a personal issue. And then I got with Viola and then got with Rosie Argano, who I hear, by the way, is returning. Did you watch that strange video with those three women's? Yes, actually, it's been propping up. Nobody knows where the source of it's coming on, but somehow it's being uploaded onto Rainbow of Madness's website and on their YouTube channel. I was talking about that. Apparently, the world is coming to an end. They've, so-called predictions, or visions, or whatever they're called, and apparently your name propped up, apparently you're gonna get injured very soon, and you're gonna need medical attention ASAP. Yes, I did watch that. I'm a bit, you know, I'm starting to think if there's anything coming up this weekend that I'm gonna be doing that could possibly lead to possible news that I may get injured, but there is nothing that I've got planned. I'm just gonna be staying, you know, apparently Saturday is the Rainbow of Madness anniversary show, so that will be very interesting. I've been looking forward to doing an anniversary show, and it's going to be apparently a big blockbuster show with a lot of celebrations, and every character is going to have a lot of fun things to do. It is going to be a very good fiesta, and I'm really looking forward to it. Thank you very much for that, El Paparando. So, before we begin with your other topics, we want to quickly talk about June 22nd, Trash Talk Championships, your match against Lady C. The Trash Talk Championship sort of spawned because of what you did at Lady C's wedding, and since then a lot of other rivalries have just suddenly occurred. You know, you got Jill Marmalade, who's going to be on here later on the show, who's feuding with Dean Johnson at the moment, Viola and Jenny, which were just chucked together, but they've seemed to get something on, and our other guest later on in the show, Asher, said she wants to sort of make a challenge herself, or there's challenges open that she would like to take part in. But what you did at Lady C's wedding caused the Trash Talk Championships to spawn. Were you expecting this to occur? Yes, I sort of wanted something like this, you know, not a physical fight, because, you know, it would be unfair for me to kick Lady C's ass, but you really think you would kick Lady C's ass?
Well, yes, I think I could do that very easily, yes.
Okay.
What, don't you believe me?
It's not, no, let's just change, let's just get back onto the topic. So you versus Lady C, June 22nd, what is your strategy? Have you got a game plan set to go face against the woman that's pretty much incorruptible? You know, you've seen so much abuse on her Facebook wall, as I've seen it. Loads of people criticize and slag her off. It doesn't seem to faze her at all, especially when she reads it for the first time on her live shows.
Well, yes, I do have to admit she is a very tough woman. I mean, she is very, very stubborn, you know, and on June 22nd, I have no doubt in my mind that it's going to be an epic match. But I do have a few tricks up my sleeve.
And apparently Lady C, she had a secret about you when you interrupted her show?
Oh no, she is just doing that to get into my mind. There is no secret about the Paparondo that nobody knows. Are you sure? You know, because this could affect your match, especially affect your game plan of trying to defeat Lady C on June 22nd in the Threshold Championships.
Well, if she's got a secret, let her say it, because I have got the heart of steel, and I'm gonna kick her ass!
Brilliantly said, El Paparando. Quickly, before we say our farewells, you did an album, a song from an album that you've got released in Italy, and only one song was sung in English.
It's Spain that it's being released in.
Sorry, it's just because of the fact you went back in Italy last week that I keep thinking about it. There's another question I want to ask you in a minute. But you got a single available on iTunes at the moment. It's your adaptation of Alejandro.
Yes.
Where did that spawn off?
Well, it was only just basically my record designers and stuff said we've got enough time for you to record one more song, and I thought this would be the perfect opportunity to slag Lady C off to sort of give me some leverage over her leading up to Trestor Championship, so I thought I would create this song for her.
Well, that is a very good game maneuver. Also would like to say, a lot of people have been wondering this. Are you Spanish, French, Italian, or Mexican?
I am Spanish, of course, yes!
You have the mannerisms of a Frenchman. You talk in the style of an Italian with a Spanish/Mexican/French/Italian accent. What's going on with that?
I don't know what you're talking about. Farewells.
Anyhow. Thank you very much, El Paparando.
You just sounded like me just then.
Sorry. Thank you very much for being on our show.
It was a pleasure.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was El Paparando. Oh, God, I'm already knocking off the set. Still to come, Jill Marmalade and Escher to be on the show. Escher will be singing, ending the show with an a cappella song. Whether it's her own or an actual song, we'll be finding out more about that later on. So, tune in after this song, where we're going to have our next guest on the show, who's been a very powerful speaker. Speecher. God. Someone please take me to school. Anyhow. Yes, she's been a very powerful voice in the world of Rainbow of Madness. I'm just emailing our executive to see which song we're going to be relaying here. And apparently, is this the song we're going to have? Right. Ladies and gentlemen, here's the latest song from Lady C's album. Please enjoy. This is called Sweet Creams.
Hello, people.
It's time
to get tasting with some cream.
Yes! You say you cheat.
Every night I look in my bed, turns out my neighbors are stuffing drag. I wanna give him some head, I want him between my legs. He woke up last night cooking fried eggs. I want him, everybody, I just want him, my pains.
That did not make sense.
And then the script writer's trying to ruin me with 50 pints.
Yay!
So kind of sweet dreams or a beautiful nightmare. Either way, I don't want to wake up from your sweet dreams or a beautiful nightmare. Hang on a minute, I'm singing all of Beyonce's lyrics. I'm a guilty pleasure, I've got no hair, I've got no underwear, I've garments everywhere. I want a sweet cream and a buttered sandwich. Everybody just wants a taste of mine. Every time I see you in Maine, I wanna wake up with you next to me, with your hands sliding up and down of my legs. I wish you could fertilize me like the way you fertilize my eggs. Eggs, eggs. I want a baby and a beautiful nightmare. What the hell does this song even mean? You can't download this song off iTunes. I would rather eat a pile of dog shit. I won't think Johnson's underwear. Shove it down my breast. Let me rearrange my chase. A guilty pleasure, I have got no pink hair. My underwear is in Pink Johnson's hair. I want a sweet cream or buttered sandwich. Either way, I don't want to wake up from your ass. I'm Lady Sam. So I will remain. Not even death could make me fart. Everybody wants to see my creams and a beautiful nightmare. Sweet creams or a buttered sandwich. I got sweet creams or a buttered sandwich. I've got hair underwear. So, my guilty pleasure, I haven't got no pink hair. Dean Johnson's got underwear, he's got cum all everywhere. Oops, that was a pop bomb or a buttered sandwich. I want some sweet cream, I want some buttered sandwich. And butter sandwich. I want a butter sandwich.
That was Lady C's. I don't even know what to call that. I don't know if that was a song or just her thinking of things on the spot. So next, ladies and gentlemen, requesting music in the background for some reason is Jill Marmalade, who's our next guest. So let's get you on. Jill Marmalade, welcome to the show.
Welcome.
So, why do we have to have this music in the background?
It's because I've got something to say and get off my chest.
Okay, mic's all yours.
Dean Johnson, I know you're listening. It's just a matter of 1 week to go before my verbal words kick your ass. I'm the preacher of the preachless. I am the speech of the voiceless. And we will demand justice across the world. This justice is gonna make me pure than the sanity dreams of which you wave your future and destinies embodied within the soils of the maiden named Earth. This, I can smell pot.
What?
I can smell pot.
I
can smell pot, and you're smoking it in the name of justice.
What the heck is going on?
I haven't got a lot of time, y'all. Well, actually, I got about a minute and 19 seconds. And within those time, I'm going to tell Dean Johnson what I think of him.
You've been doing that for the past 3 weeks.
Dean Johnson, I know you're listening. You're nothing but a shriveled shrimp. You laughing at me?
Sorry, that didn't make any sense.
What do you mean it didn't make sense? Did the Lord, Hulk Custrus, make sense when he devoured the lands?
Who?
Or did the soils grow the plants of which beneath have weeded?
I don't actually know if you're actually talking English.
How dare you sanitize my sanctity? This world will be a better place without Dean Johnson. I know you're listening to me. It's gonna be over before you know it, before I kick your ass at the Trash Tour Championships in 2012.
Did you actually prepare anything before coming on the show?
I've gotta go now. I've got a justice-ified revolution to make.
Well, that was our, I'm trying not to laugh because we got a small mini camera on our monitors here, and the technician's girl has just not stopped laughing throughout the whole of that interview. Come to think of it, it does smell like pot in here. So yes, we got an extra song now to fill up before Esha does her acapella to finish up the show later on. So here is another song from Lady C's album. I don't know why we only play Lady C things. here in this show. But, well, we're trying to find something for all of you to listen to, because we weren't expecting another song after that, well, strange performance. So, have we got another one? This is really making a great TV time, don't you think? Oh, God. Okay, then. Is it ready now? Right. Enjoy. This is a duet between Santa Gold and Lady C doing a duo. This is actually a proper song, surprisingly. So, here we go. This is my girl, Santa Gold! Let's sing it together, girls! Lights out. Shoot up the station. TV's dead, there's no TV run. Watch everybody come undone. Lights out, we'll make it easy. We'll make it fun. Won't let's need now. How they want. Still, I wait another round. Darling, don't go worry, you locked in tight. Yes, darling, don't go to worry, turn out the light. Take a sip of my drink, Santa Gold, you're doing great. Wipe tail, no concentration, they got us baking up a cake. Dean Johnson, go home and fish in a lake. Lights out, Alice, care can't act to save her life. I think she's lesbian, she'll need a wife. She looks like an ugly dyke, darling. Don't worry, you're locked in tight. Darling, don't gotta worry, turn out the light. Dean Johnson and Alice, you smell like shake. I'm still, no. Look at my vage. Lady Sadie's eight. I'm still a shaking my height. The one you can't account for. I keep just one step ahead. There's no place to run. Darling, I think my ass has gotten real tight. Darling, Alice Carey is number one in the right. Darling, darling, save him a drink, puff him a vape, darling. Don't worry, Dean Johnson's face is white. Darling, people thought I was black, no, I'm white. Darling, my baby's gone out in the trash. Darling, who ate all my pork and my mash? Take a shave. Well, Well, that was interesting. So, I think it's time to get our number one guest here on the show, ladies and gentlemen. She has sold over 43,000 copies on the first hour of the album's release in Germany, singing in a full 22-hit soundtrack, and has done a lot of work in the acting business in Germany. She spent a lot of time in there, has now come back to her own country again. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got our guest, Escher, on the show. How does it feel to... Well, how are you, Escher?
I'm good, thank you. I'm very good.
Tell us about this thing in Germany that you've done. You know, you left university last year, and you went off, and you just took a lot of people by storm with what you did.
Well, I've always wanted to go to Germany. It's a beautiful country, and I went there, and I was in a bar one night, and it was karaoke. And so I got up, I sang, and then after I'd sung, I went to the bar, got a drink, and this man approached me. He was like, I really like your singing. Would you like to come down to the studio at some point and record some songs? And so I did. Some were English, some were German. And I released my first album in Germany, and it sold really well.
Yes, it sold over 32,000 copies within the first hour. That's 32,000 CDs of your album sold within an hour. How did that make you feel? That was the biggest record in Europe.
I was speechless at the time. I really was. I didn't know how to react. It was amazing.
And it's a 22 soundtrack. You got 22 songs there, and half of the album, I believe, is a cappella. Why choose a cappella sometimes?
I think you get more freedom when you don't have music, because I think each time you sing a song, it's different, and you get new ideas of how to sing the notes and stuff, and I just think it's more freedom for the singer, really.
So, I believe you told us, the studio director who were on today, that you're going to be singing a bit of a cappella today. Is it your own piece, or is it a cover song?
No, it's a cover.
Of what?
This, by Ed Sheeran.
Oh, well. Any Ed Sheeran fans out there, you're in for a treat. And, yes, we got a few things we want to, talk about. First of all, you went to university for how many years? Apparently you got the top grades in Germany and all the other subjects. You left university a couple of years ago. What were your ambitions at that time before going to Germany and did what you did?
Well, acting has always been my main passion. It's what I've always wanted to do. And, so that performing has always been what I've wanted to do, really.
And obviously now you've got the singing career. You're going to be planning to do a singing career for the European market, like the American and English market, or is this just a one-off for Germany?
No, I think I'll continue and be more solely English now. German's quite hard.
So, yes, also we want to talk about is your role in Rainbow Madness. Not a lot of people are aware of this, but you were part of the original Rainbow Madness crew before Rainbow Madness became what it is.
Yeah.
You went from doing random videos, then you just left for a while, and then you probably came back. You did some shoots in the Pokemon episodes, played by David and you, which were quite entertaining. But yes, now that you've got yourself a solid contract, I believe, in Rainbow Madness, how long is the contract agreement?
About 2 years.
Two-year contract with Rainbow Madness, and I bet that's paying you quite well.
Yes, very.
Also, we would like to note that the Trash Talk Championships is next Friday. We've already got some great matches between them. We want to quickly get your votes on who do you think is going to win. Who do you think is going to win out of Viola and Jenny?
Viola.
And also, Jill Marmalade and Dean Johnson.
Jill.
Now, why do you pick Jill Marmalade?
Well, I don't know if she will, but I want her to because she's just so funny. She can't speak. It's hilarious.
And obviously the big question, Lady C and El Paparando. There's lots of speculation that Lady C's got the so-called secret, but I think El Paparando's got something in the bag because he does not seem affected by this. Who do you think is going to win this?
El Paparando.
And obviously the winner of that will get a prime time slot over the other person, so that's going to be interesting to see. But you haven't got a match, but I hear that you want to get a match.
Yeah, I think it'd be quite fun.
We've heard that El Macho's actually put an advertisement statement that he's willing to challenge anyone. Would you take up against El Macho's?
Maybe, yeah.
What did you call El Macho's earlier on? I believe it was like a steroided version of Rey Mysterio, was it?
Yeah, Rey Mysterio on steroids.
So, at the Trash Talk Championships, if you did get nominated, would you be partaking in the event next Friday?
Yeah, sure.
And are you going to be part of the Saturday episode of the 6-month anniversary episode of Rainbow Madness on Saturday?
If they'll have me.
Well, yes, I think David wants to get the whole cast. He wants everyone, even people that, have only been in it for smidges, including that random Hong Kong video that was made about 5 months ago, if you didn't watch
it. Don't remind me.
He wants the entire cast for a huge, spectacular show. What would you do if you got, asked what would you like to do in your show segment? Would it be your own little vlog, or would you actually do your own vlog and also do a song as well?
I think I'd do a bit of...
both?
Yeah, or maybe a bit of stand-up as well.
Well, that will be interesting. That will make the 6-month extravaganza huge, and obviously the 1-year anniversary will be next January. That will be a huge, huge episode. But, one other thing we want to ask about. Not many people are aware of this, but you've had a wrestling career in the past with WWE.
I have.
you know, the 1,000th episode of WWE Raw is coming up. Have you been invited by Vince McMahon, or have you got too much going on that you can't attend the event?
He hasn't invited me to do anything, but he says I'm free to, if I want to go and attend backstage, then that's
well, it'll
fine.
Be good to see you on there, because a lot of WWE fans respect you. So, yes, do you want to do your, is there anything else you want to go? I've already asked all the questions that are needed.
I'm good.
Alright, so ladies and gentlemen, the song's called This. It's a cover of Ed Sheeran's song. This is Usher's a cappella version. This obviously means no music, and it's her style of singing. So please enjoy this song by Usher. Let's, alright, hit it.
This is the start of something beautiful. This is the start of something new. You are the one that makes me lose it all. You are the start of something new. And I'll throw it all away. Watch you fall into my arms again. And I'll throw it all away and watch you fall now. Oh, you are the earth that I will stand upon. You are the words that I will sing. And I've thrown it all away, watched you fall into her arms again. And I've thrown it all away and watched you fall now. Take me back, take me home, watch me fall down to earth. This is the start of something beautiful. This is the start of something new.
Well, that was brilliant! My God, I didn't expect a cappella to sound so brilliant. I actually sort of had music in my sort of head. What is that beeping noise for crying out loud? Well, thank you very much. We've had Usher. Thank you for being on the show.
Thank you for having me.
So that was Usher, ladies and gentlemen, singing a cappella. You can download her new album from the Germany one, but it's also she's done an English interpretation of the music, also available on iTunes. So we would like to leave you with, well, a nice sort of, well, addition, should I say, to this radio station. We hope that you enjoyed. And this is our next one. This is from Carla J. Simpson. I got off the bone, saying I won't know me, good to move, say, na-na-na-na, high-heeled shoes and fancy pants, mama, high-heeled shoes and fancy pants, singing, na-na-na-na, na-na-na-na, oh, na-na-na-na, na-na-na-na, oh, na-na-na-na, na-na-na-na, na-na-na-na. I walked in the door and Susan Boyle, yo, walked in the door and Susan Boyle's going, na-na-na-na, na-na-na-na. I tried my shoes on a half past 12, I tried my shoes at a half past 12, singing, na-na-na, 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 oh, na-na-na-na, Na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Till it's bread. No. Well, that was weird. Thank you very much for watching the show, ladies and gentlemen. This was Radio Blast. Radio Blast.